Are y'all ready for the next comedian?
Yeah, please.
Y'all still with my ass? Hell yeah, and this is she, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for Small Fry.
Like he said, I'm originally from Mississippi, but I live in Atlanta, so if I happen to say something you quite don't understand what I'm saying, just raise your hand and I'll translate, okay? Everybody raise your hand. How many of y'all been to church before? Church? Everybody been to church? Everybody been to church. I went to church last month because we had a family reunion. And it was in Mississippi, you know, my grandma's church, and it was a sanctified church. Y'all been to one of them? Where the preachers be knowing everything you did wrong. He called me out, right? I was like, damn, we're gonna be here all day. So I'm trying to repent all this stuff while I'm walking up to the altar, right? So I get up there. He told me to raise my hands, so I raise my hands up. Then he put the grease on my hands and on my head. Messed up my hair, too. But he ain't say nothing. He just started prophesying and stuff. He told me, he said, look, girl, he said, I'm gonna tell you something. He said, God got something in store for you. But he didn't tell me what store it was. I would have been Woolworth. I'm like, hey, y'all something here for me? They were like, nah. So anytime a man tell y'all something, make sure they be more specific. But ladies, tell the truth, because it's a major problem. But see, I'm here to help y'all. The only way you can fix a problem is first you have to recognize that problem. Am I correct? Right. Ladies, don't it seem like as soon as we get our hair done, men be trying to have sex and mess it up? Don't it? And then we have sex with them, right? Then they go to sleep. Now our hair messed up. We can't go nowhere. We sitting there looking mad till we fall asleep. Then they mad because they spent all that money. See? You have to go through that, because see, I have designed a way where we can have sex without messing up our hair. My hair been like this since Thanksgiving. I ain't missed a day yet. But see, all it takes is concentration. What's your favorite position? Doggy style. You like it doggy style, huh? So that means you be like this. You didn't say you give it doggy style, you said you like it doggy style. Well, they coming on out these days. What you like? You like the girl on top, lazy bastard. What you like, baby? The red shirt. What you like? Huh? You like being on top? What kind of position? Well, her legs. Right up there. You look kind of skinny now. Huh? You can spin me around. I'm gonna spin around. Ain't no problem. But ladies, I'm finna show y'all how to do these positions without messing up your hair. Cool? But you got to remember, at this point in time, your hair is the most important. All right? Now, we're going to start off with the doggy style position. Is everybody familiar? Is everybody familiar? Uh-huh, that's what I thought. Now, ladies, when you're in this position, you don't want to relax too much. Okay? See, the whole idea is to brace yourself. Let me show you how. See, you have a joint right here in your elbow. What you wanna do is twist and lock it. All right. See, if you lock it, that means no matter how hard it hits you, your head won't hit that bedpost. Okay. Now, I'm looking in the crowd. A lot of y'all got these long fingernails. Now, if you got long fingernails, you can't do that too often because you're gonna slip, you're gonna break a nail. So what you gonna have to do is like be on top. But you want to stretch first. You go like 10 to the left, 10 to the right, 10 in the middle. I'll tell you a secret. If you do push-ups and sit-ups, it'll build your muscles up in your legs, and it'll give you a good balance.